Thank you, Lord.
I read Romans 14:10-14.
Amen.
been thankful for this Sunday day. Be thankful, lift your hands and tell the Lord, thank you. You didn't have to do it, but you did. Thank you, Lord. Time for our responsive reading. Second Sundays. First Peter chapter 4, verse 7 through 13. By the end of all things that end, be ye therefore sober and watch unto prayer, people.
And above all things, have fervent charity among the brethren, by the charity of God
among
the
saints. Use hospitality one to another without grudging, people.
Good morning.
Good morning.
By the grace of God, I made it this far. And I want to say a happy and blessed Mother's Day to all the mothers. And I want to say to the children and to the grown people, if your mother is still living, you better cherish her. Yes, you better cherish her. When you lose them, it tears your heart out. I can truly speak on that. And not only that, I tell you, a peace of mama. You got to get home, a peace of mama is better than no mama at all. So I tell y'all, if I just had a peace of mama, and I don't care how old you get, and what you know, and what your spirits are like, that comes a time at my age, I still wish I had my mama. Yes, yes, Lord. Oh, but I tell you, but by the grace of God, I made it this far. Yes, Lord. We're speaking on behalf of Pastor Green and the entire Mount Nebo Church family. Y'all, these are our written announcements to the Oakland Baptist Church, where the pastor, Little Rome, is the pastor. Greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We are overjoyed to be celebrating our annual youth explosion on Sunday, the 9th of June, at 2:30 p.m. Our theme is ARMY, Anointed, Regaining Mighty Youth. We hereby invite the youth ministry of your church to come take part and worship with us. Bring your choir, dance ministry, a drill team to share with us as we send our praises. As we send up our praises, please contact our sister youth director to inform her of your participation or any questions you have. They have a phone number up here on the communication. The New Jerusalem Baptist Church. The New Jerusalem Baptist Church would like to cordially invite you to our musician appreciation service Sunday. This is May the 19th. We would love for your choir to perform an A and B selection. Come on out and help show our love and support to our minister of music, Sister Moesha Rambo, anointed by God and loved by us all. Service starts at 2:30 p.m. Be blessed and we look forward to seeing you. Thanks in advance to your participation in this celebration. Okay, Eastside Baptist Church, Brother Pastor Tommy Thomas is the pastor. Please join us as we celebrate our annual musician appreciation program on Sunday, May the 19th at 2:30 p.m. honoring Minister Dinkins and Brother Frankie Thomas. Your choir is asked to render an A and B selection or solo. Thank you for your continued prayers and support. On our sick and shut-in list, this is Sis Nash, Sis Helen Ireland, Sister Georgia Turner, Brother Fred Baxter. Y'all, Sister Sue is here today. Yeah. We thank y'all for that. Sister Shirley Gibson and y'all, Deacon McCoy is here today. Yeah. And I want to bless the Lord. Yeah, we know what the Lord can do.
Amen.
Okay. Okay, speaking of the floods. And we hope something is said and done that will keep y'all encouraged in Jesus Christ. Again, y'all are welcome. Y'all, that's Sister Victoria's sister there with the orange dress on.
Amen.
with a quiet voice.
The baby is getting out of the hospital. He's at home now.
Would a choir please stand and march around to the table, please?
Anybody heard from the young man who was baptized last
Sunday?
Anybody? Amen. Amen. God bless you. Thank you. I've been asleep. Amen. Mission means that you're about doing something.
Right.
Amen. Visiting sick. Amen. Helping those in hell. You can say what you will about Jehovah's Witnesses. I remember my neighbor got sick. And every day, there was nothing from that church to take care of her. Every day. They did not until they passed, until she passed. Now, we got to learn how to help one another. Amen. Amen. We got to learn how to help one another. Amen. If you're too busy to help, you're too busy. Sooner or later, you're going to need some help. It is amazing that people always want folks to do for them when they have done for nobody. And what you send into somebody else's life will come back in your own. You help somebody and watch God help you. Also, come on to the end. Down front of the name. Come on, church. Pray for me. Down front.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God is good. And all the time God is good. We've chosen these, or you have chosen your officers to lead youth appointment and the mission into doing real work. Amen. It's not going to be just something that we get away on time. It's time to get busy. Amen. Every day, especially those of us that's not working, right. The iron mind is the devil's work. Amen. Sometimes while we run here thinking up so much mess. Amen. Isn't it work?
Right.
Amen.
Right.
Hands on these. Thank you for being this Lord. Father, we pray that you will touch, motivate, lift them up, give them a wheel and a spirit to work while it is day. Night coming, don't make it work. Touch it right now. Lord, you know you're able. You can do anything but fail. When they're being talked about, keep working. When they're being lied on, keep working. When they're being knocked down, keep working. Touch right now. Give us the faith, the will to stand. In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Mine is gone. but she left me with something. She taught me how to survive. How to take care of myself. You may not hear me say much about my dad because he wasn't there. Amen. Mama shouldered that burden. Mama had to take me to the doctor. And you know that man sound like, because she has a baby out of warm with seizures. And she would have to run and pick me up. Now the doctor wasn't a block. She had to get 4 miles just to catch a bus. For those of mama back here. I know y'all done cooked, and some of y'all going out. Y'all go cook so I can go and get them a plate. You know, I'm staying there all day. Amen. The other word of the Lord, and we're not going to bother you all day. Proverbs chapter 14. Chapter 14. And we just want to deal with verse 1 for a few minutes if it's the Lord's will.
When they're not supposed to.
But it takes a wife to know that. A wife knows her place. I'm glad I got y'all here. And some of y'all are looking for husbands, and you all not be looking for a husband, I'll be looking for you.
Yeah.
And if you live the right life, your husband will find you.
Yeah.
Right.
Amen.
Come on,
Pastor. Wise. Wise woman. Those that are not wise, Proverbs say it's better to dwell in the corner of the house top than to dwell in the house for a brawling woman.
All right.
Maybe y'all learned this today.
All right.
Women have the tendency to say things that could. They don't play fair. They hit you where it hurts.
All right.
Well, I know. That young man's gonna be quiet. I'm not mistaken. That's
all right.
They know the words to say to cause you to drop your head and make you feel like you ain't nobody. Meet you at the door like a pit bull. You've been working all day. Don't even get a man a chance to get in the house and sit down and relax. They may take my man, but I ain't giving him away. Some women are giving their husbands to other women because when the man come home, there's no peace. There's no quiet. There's no rest when he come home. All of them get home, all that noise, all that arguing and fussing. Let me put a pin in that. We need to understand one thing. Arguments does not make a strong relationship. Some of us in relationships now that we cuss before we go to bed. We cuss when we get up. And then when our children act right, they hear us moving back that cussing. Can't get along. We want the children to get along. And we're supposed to be that example. That's why I need wise woman. Be in the car. I'm 65 years old. I never saw my mom, with a man. I didn't say she didn't have her. I said, I never saw her. Why is women do not just bring men over the house, over there, and shoot them? I watched the news. They arrested this young man that killed this boy. What did this happen? The mama got another man and brought that man in the house. That man killed her child.
All right.
Look at somebody said, you better be careful. Everything that looks good ain't necessarily good.
You got
men running around with diseases, ain't telling nobody. Let me tell you something. Some of this stuff you can't get rid of.
All right.
I said, some of the stuff you can't get rid of. You got a pain in your stomach. Don't understand why. Somebody left you something.
All right.
You got to be careful. Somebody said, you got to be careful. You can't rip and run now.
Right now.
I'm almost good. Can you low and roll over here? Shake and bake over here.
That's right.
You'll come up with something.
Yeah. All right. catching something.
Amen.
All I want to catch is a biscuit. Some pork pie. It's dangerous. A wise woman teaches her daughter. She don't hunger. She teaches her. Your daughter's free. You ain't over my daughter, Mama. I told you, I ain't your friend, boy. I'm your dad. I don't run with you. We're trying to tell them what to do. And they see you bring that man in the house. That ain't your hood. Go back in the bedroom. They know you ain't going back there for milk and cookies.
All right.
A wise woman. Don't let any and everything coming down. Over their children. The Bible says she built it. She built it. A man can be the best that he can be if he got a wise wife. You see, women, just like they know how to tag it out, they know how to build it up. Remember, let me tell you some stuff. I had you walking with your head in the sky and your chest all back, and they might not mean none of it, but they just tag it out. Make them feel better. Talk to me, somebody. A real woman knows how to make a man feel good. They know just what to say to make you bounce back. You've been having a problem on the job all day long. You get home, and when she gets through with it, you done forgot all of the problems. Oh, I know what I'm talking about in here. When she gets through, that's a wise woman. Listen. A wise woman never have to ask. She'll take them by herself. She don't know about it. She knows it. She'll take them by herself. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. I like that. Let's go. And I'm going back to the house. She's thinking, I'm going to get my wife this. She does. She likes it. I'm going to surprise her. I did a surprise, but she had a surprise. She knew you were going to do it. That's why she took you off. A real wise woman knows how to get what she wants without arguing. She bet it. She bet it though. By the way, some of these friends you got coming in, you need to stop. Because not everybody is up to good. Some folks are really up to no good. They want to find out all they can find out about you so they can spread. And those that are in your house all the time, those are the ones you got to block. They don't give you enough slack to use the bathroom before they pop up. They don't give you enough slack to rest before they pop up. And in your kitchen, they get your pop. Bring in your house and wreck your house. I'm almost thinking on a holiday. What you bring in your house can wreck your house. I know what I'm talking about. But you have to learn from it. You have to learn from it. I've learned to start feeding folks a long time ago. And not in the manufacturer's room, the one I cut myself, make sure it's real long. I don't hate you, I don't dislike you, but I don't want you around. People that can't be trusted should be around you. I'm trying to help you out.
many here know your wives? How many know your wives? How many know your wives? A wise woman built a house. But a fool. Tear him with her hand. A foolish woman. You can't do nothing to satisfy. She never gets enough. You can buy a dress. Party boots. Lord have mercy. You can get a house. She want a better house. And men don't have no better. But always know what they want. You ought to be thankful for what you got. We need more wise women. Those that know how to please God. You got to understand a wise woman can make a man eat out of her hand and never say a word. Because she knows how to carry herself. A wise woman don't have to wear many with pity. She can wear a dress down to her ankle, and a man will still want her because she's wise. You got to understand, because a wise woman, a beautiful woman, but a fool will tear you down. Why, the word of God said, a foolish woman is that rotten to your bone.
God, I live.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, Jesus. God bless you. Around here, we don't teach young women more than how to drop it like an eye.
know you Sunday is on the fourth Sunday, so on the third Sunday, I'll go to that one, participate with you. We're like going with devotion and stuff. Be here third Sunday, so we let you know what you want to do. And even if we, like I told Sister Kim, we have to get up there with whatever, we're going to do what the Lord wants to do. And if you don't want to participate or whatever, we're still going to do what we're going to do. Because we got to help our children. Our children is going to be the church today. So we need to make a move, not let our children feel us what we need to take back and do like the Lord wants to do, raise our children. So on the third Sunday, our fellows that want to participate, you want to learn how to do the devotion, learn how to get up and talk in the church, pray and stuff like that. Be here on the third Sunday. You don't have to do that third Sunday, but we're going to let you know what you're going to have to do for the fourth Sunday so we can be ready to do what you're going to have to do.
Amen. Amen. So everybody bring your children. Amen. I believe, you know, that it's no harm in playing basketball. But you need to have facility if you want to do that. You can't do it in church. This is a place to come to worship. You know, we talk about white people, but they build places. Amen. To take their children. Amen. Even some white church.
Yes.
Amen. Pastor Don Hamilton built a deal out there for him to play basketball. Amen. We just got to get busy. Amen. Stop wanting everything for ourselves and start to help it others. Amen. God bless you. And we get ready to go so hard. Just on pins and even bless us. So y'all let me count my feet. Somebody gonna feed some daughter? Huh? Quick. You taking your mama to dinner?
No, okay.
She's smiling like somebody gonna take her to eat. And we know she won't cook. Huh? Say she gonna cook. Oh, she gonna bring it. Yeah, that's good. What time you bring it? Supposed to tell me what time. So it won't get there. I had to go back to my house.
Alright.
Thank God for them. Love your mothers. Love them. In fact, go ahead and give them a hug right now. Love your mom. Love your mom. You still got a hug. Let them know you love them.
Amen. 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 Am